Ananya and Naftali, great to be with you. And you're really so well known on social media. You're a social media influencer. What's the main message you try to get across on all your platforms?
Well, one thing that guides me is that Israel is not, of course, free of blemishes, but it's absurd that Israel is being treated like it is the world's biggest problem. And we, you know, I served in the IDF, I fought Hamas in the Gaza Strip, and I saw how we were treating Palestinians, I saw how we were fighting there. We were given strict commands to preserve human life, and you know, then you see on international media, international forums, that Israel is being bashed for things that we didn't do. So the one thing that motivated me is, you know, to share the truth about Israel, to not apologize for defending Israel. We have nothing to apologize for. We are doing the right thing, and this is what the world needs to know.
Yeah, so how do you respond to people when they accuse Israel of being an apartheid nation?
What, my favorite response is to invite them to Israel. Come to Israel, see, right now we are in Jerusalem, the capital of Israel. You see here Jews, Christians, and Muslims alike living together. When it's evening, you hear the church bell, you hear the mosque calling for prayer. You see Jews going to pray at the Western Wall. So we coexist, and those that call Israel as an apartheid state, they know nothing about Israel. They are being misled by the international media, by things that they heard. I'm pretty sure that they have never been to Israel, so I invite them to come to Israel.
Yeah, so you fought Hamas in one of the recent conflicts, and just in May, there was another 11-day war between Israel and Hamas. How would you describe the way Israel was portrayed in much of the media?
Well, in the recent conflict, I was sitting in front of my computer combating these lies, and one thing that I really noticed is that people really don't know what Israel is. You know, people have an idea of what Israel is like, what Israel is doing, and they like to cling to stereotypes, to things that they heard before, and we need to break down these lies that are misleading people. And Israel was being portrayed as an aggressor, as a country that commits crimes against humanity, committing crimes against children in Gaza, Palestinians. But let me tell you this, I'm an Israeli-born Jew, I served in the IDF, and I love Palestinians. Does the world think that we Israelis hate Palestinians? Does the world think that our IDF troops prefer to be on the border instead of being back home? Obviously not, you know? So the world needs to understand that we are not committing crimes against humanity. You know, one thing that a lot of people don't know, it's that when you join the IDF, the first thing that you are given is not a weapon. It is this small booklet that teaches you about the values of the IDF. It's called the IDF Code of Ethics. They teach you how to preserve human life, treat people with dignity, and only then you are taught how to defend the country.
Mm. Would you say that you were there on the battlefield, literally, and there was another battlefield just back in May, would you say you're on another battlefield right now, the battlefield for truth and in media around the world?
Exactly right. You know, as I've said earlier, in 2014, I was inside the Gaza Strip fighting Hamas. In the recent conflict, I was fighting Hamas on social media and fighting these lies. And let me tell you this, the war may be over, but we still have an ongoing battle on social media, on the media, on every, you know, you literally just need to open your phone and see what's going on. There's an ongoing battle. We need to share the truth as an Israeli. I am combating these lies because I have nowhere else to go. This is my homeland.
So what would you encourage people on their own social media platforms to do in defense of Israel?
Very easy. First of all, I do encourage you to pray for Israel. You know, as a believer in God, I feel these prayers. I feel stronger, I feel encouraged. So I would say this is number one. Number two, join conversations. If you hear something about Israel, why be silent? Why be silent? And number three, share the truth. Share the truth. Take content. You don't need to have a camera and have script, write things down and talk to the camera. You just need to share the truth. You know, everybody, has social media nowadays, and it could be used to do something good.
Yeah, you have huge followings on your social media platforms, but for those that haven't seen or heard about you, how can they follow you?
I wasn't that original, so you just need to write on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, my name, Hanania Naftali, and you'll be able to find it and join this ongoing battle, because we need more and more and more people.
Yeah, Hanania Naftali, great to be with you.
Thank you very much.